Yo, what's up, YouTubes? Oh my gosh. All right, so last video you just watched was me, you know, prepping my hay plot and getting things ready because I'm going to try and take on some custom baling. I'm going to try to this year, but who even knows if that happens. Yeah, I just got back from Nebraska. Hung out with Zach for the weekend after about a year, so that was freaking awesome. Me and him picked up right where we left off. It was awesome, so that was cool. I'm gonna grab my Bluetooth thingamabobber jigger out of the car. But anyway, today we are gonna be going to run some errands for my hayfield. We are gonna be going to, well, I gotta go pick up my boots from the place that fixes them. I don't even freaking know what the heck it's called. But anyway, had to get new soles put on them, rub some holes in them from swing dancing, you bet. So I got the new Aerie Kilos on today. These things are like dude shoes, but like they're 20 times better than dude shoes, dude. Look at that, freaking sick. But like they are like the most comfiest shoe I have ever put on my feet. Got my wallet in my pocket. Yeah, all right. But, what was I gonna say? Frick! Hey, when I do that. I literally cannot stand when people freaking call me in the middle of vlogging. Cause then it cuts the audio off and no one knows what I freaking said. Got gunk in my throat. Alright, so anyway, that was Ryan that called me, and I called Ryan yesterday when I got back into town. I was like, hey, do I need to come out to the farm at all tomorrow? I got 3 days that I could be helpful. And he's like, I'll let you know. And then he calls me at freaking 1:30 and asks if I'm coming out or not. So we're gonna grab my boots, gonna go grab some seed and fertilizer. And then we're gonna go to Ryan's, and I think we're gonna be cleaning the 305 and the 7800 probably. I'm not too sure exactly what's going on out there. I mentioned it, so we'll see. Oh yes, the Amish are getting her done, bud. But yeah, we got her here at Birkdale's, and it's where I'm gonna get my seed. This is actually like where I get like all my stuff. We get dog food, get rock, get tools. It's a Mennonite place. Yeah, come check them out in Mount Vernon, Illinois. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave my truck on because that's kind of what you do. I'm just gonna do it. I don't care. All right, so we got about 200 pounds of triple 12 fertilizer, and then we have this forage overrun mix, which I'll explain that in the truck, but we're loaded down, ready to go. Alright, so a forage overrun mix is basically the guy who was mixing up the mixture for the bags screwed up somehow or another. And so it's got like, it's like 80 or it's probably 70% orchard grass, which is fine. And then it's got like 10%, probably 15% alfalfa, and then I think another some odd percent for Timothy. It's orchard grass, Timothy, and alfalfa, which is originally what I was gonna do. I was gonna plant that. But they didn't have just regular like 50 pound bags of alfalfa and stuff like that. So it's not that big of a deal. I could have ordered some probably in, you know, separate bags and then mixed it myself, but it's not that big of a deal. But anywho, got it loaded down. I need to call my grandpa and figure out the fertilizer spreader, because I think we got one for the gator, but I ain't too sure, so I don't know. Look at this freaking crackhead. What the frick, dude? I did forget I need to go pick up my boots. So we're gonna go to the boot repair store, grab my boots, and pay more money. Golly, you don't even want to know what I paid for grass seed fertilizer. Holy frick. Okay, so they give you a ticket, okay? a ticket whenever you take your boots in there. And they're like, okay, it's your ticket, bring it back, we'll give you your boots. And I literally told them what my boots were and what I had done to them, and they still won't let me take the boots because I don't have my freaking ticket. What if I lost my ticket? Huh? Yeah. They don't keep track of your phone number or your name. It's all by a flipping ticket number. At this point, I don't even care about the boots. I really don't even care. They can keep the son of bitches. I'm up with Smear to the farm compound. Ryan. Brian. Les sets his semi. Oh yeah. I'm removing these farm walls and cleaning out the shop. And we need to hook that bar on the 305 and get it ready so I can wash it and we can clean it. Yep. Stuff, dude. All right, we're gonna go move this mule so we can get the skid loader out, dump some trash out to the burn pit. So that's reverse. Don't want to hit my truck. Dude, shoot, I might have to move my truck to be honest. We got the bucket on now. All right, Ryan, you need a lighter.
There's one in there.
Why does he look like that?
Why do you look like that?
Dude, I'm not even talking to you, dude. I'm talking to the people. They're wondering why you probably look like that, too.
Why?
Where the frick's my Merchman cooler?
I don't know where any of ours are either.
Yeah, I freaking want mine.
Dude, we're missing like three or four of them, brah.
Yep, I had my own cooler last year that Greg gave me. Gary. And then we used it in the red Duramax, and now it's gone. Someone stole my cooler. I'm not having it. Okay. We're gonna burn a seat. It'll catch. I think. What's the devilish derby? Belt, how about now? Oh yes, get her done, bud. Go ahead, Ryan. It's there on the block. Oh yes. Yeah, you bet. Good stuff. One-handed, you bet. One-handed, come on. Me and Ryan got the fifth wheel cleaned up, and we're gonna be putting some icky stuff on there. This is the satisfying part.
Turn plate.
No. That's a greased fifth wheel, if you ask me. Yeah, make yourself useful and go to the trailer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Freaking
idiot, dude. This is our new hopper bottom. We sold the other one. I think we sold it. I think it's gone now. But they just picked this up like early summer. But it's pretty brand new. It's only had like three loads ran through it. But yeah, you bet. I can't wait to use this trailer, honestly. The worst part of this and waiting for it to go all the way up the jacks. That's the worst part I hate. Or this is what I hate most. I hope I said that right.
Hey, about his go international. Freaking hate this semi with a passion.
We're gonna park this sucker.
All right, we moved her forward here, and it's getting a little bit of grease on her, you bet. I did my part over here, cleaned it off and spread it, and now Ryan's doing the rest. Fifth wheel sit her on there and spread her out like a pancake, bud, you bet.
What are you doing, Ryan? He's like that farmer's little kid that just annoys the shit out of all the hired hands. He's that guy.
Hi.
Here.
Hi.
Put it up. Good boy. Good job, buddy. Proud of you. Where do you want it parked?
I guess just throw it over there, buddy.
Okay, I'm doing burnout. Is there a rat nest in there? Okay. I missed running truck for harvest.
All right.
Shut up, Ryan. What?
Hello.
What are you looking at, dude?
I don't know what I'm looking at.
We should play Demolition Derby with sim ass. Perfect.
Bye.
All right, so we're gonna hook this bar. And, I'm just gonna do the thing. 305 Magnum. Big honk. Yeah, talk about a safety chain. Look at that thing. Cripes. Good job, Ryan. Yeah, put it in there like that. Yep. Yep, doing a good job, man. Look at that.
That there is handy. Handy dandy. Good job, John Deere.
Did something good for once. Come on. Come on, Ryan. Come on, Ryan. Let's go, Ryan. Come on with it, Ryan. I didn't know what Ryan's doing.
Better drip her back, bud.
Whoa!
Yeah. What the frick, man?
Good freaking deal, dude. Alright, so I moved my fertilizer and my seed. I'm gonna grab this chemical tank. I'm gonna take it home with me. Cause I need one and they don't need this anymore. So now I have to adjust my forks. Alrighty. Get it loaded up on the old flatbed, you bet. Oh yeah. Alright, y'all. So got the old flatbed loaded down. Tomorrow I'm going to have to grab my boots from the place with my ticket. And then I need to go drop off this fertilizer and seed. I still need to find out what off our fertilizer spreader is over at my grandpa's. I'm not too sure. But anyway, we're going to be using this probably for like some oil and stuff. Just to dump oil in. So I don't know. But anywho, that pretty much sums it up for just like your day with BMO. Yeah, not much here today. So, anyway, plug Northern Chill, you bet. Use code BMO 20 for 20% off your case order. Also, plug Ariat. Can't forget them. The Helos are plugged today. I will put the discount code down in the description if you guys are interested in the link to the Northern Chill. If you're interested in Tritterco hat, also link will be in the description. We also have Tritterco shirts. Got new merch coming out, so check that out. But anyway, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Let me know what y'all want to see. I just kind of like gonna be vlogging like my everyday stuff, so it's not like that crazy to harvest. But it's just, yeah, it's kind of how it goes. So anyway, toodaloo, and catch y'all later.